Good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about module number 2, that is line parameters. Here we are going to discuss about the electric field of a long straight conductor and inductance. So first of all, here we are going to discuss about the electric field of a long straight conductor. So before going to discuss about the electric field of a long straight conductor, first of all, what is meant by electric potential? Electric potential is at a point due to a charge. That means if you take one conductor at any one point due to the charge, that is the amount of work done in bringing one unit positive charge from infinity to that point. That means the amount of the work what we done to bring that one positive charge from again or from another infinity to that point. The concept of electric potential is important for the evaluation of the capacitance. That means if I want to discuss very clear about that, the concept called capacitance, because capacitance C is equal to Q by V, that is the amount of charge per unit voltage is called as a capacitance. So that charge has to be done. For that we have to do some amount of work. Okay, now when that unit of positive charge which is moving from infinity to that point, therefore electric field is very important when the capacitance is considered, because C is equal to Q by V, and the lines of electric flux originates from the positive charges of one conductor and terminates from the negative charges of the other conductor. That means always charge flows from one positive terminal to another negative terminal, because always current flows in a closed circuit where current is flowing from higher potential terminal to the lower potential terminal. So in this case also, where the positive charges of one conductor terminates from the negative charges of the other conductor, therefore the electric flux is nothing but emanating from a conductor which is numerically equal to the number of coulombs of a charge on a conductor. That means electric flux density is nothing but electric flux per square meter. Electric flux density is nothing but electric flux per square meter, and electric flux density is measured in coulombs per square meter, because the units of here charge is coulombs. So electric flux is depends upon current. So we can define the units of electric flux density is coulombs per square meter. If we consider E is equal L into di by dt, where E is the induced voltage and L is the constant and I is the current will change as with respect to the time. If the permeability is not constant, because most of the cases permeability is constant, but in some cases where permeability is not constant, then the above equation may also be used, but inductance is not constant. Here inductance L is not constant because it is variable. How it is variable? Because if you look at the equation, that is L is equal d psi by dt. That means L is equal d psi by dt Henry. The units of inductance is Henry. That is here psi. Psi is nothing but n into pi. N is constant. If you take n to be left hand side, then d pi by dt. Pi is directly proportional to again current. Therefore L is equal n into di by dt. L is equal n into di by dt Henry's. That is d psi by dt is equal capital L into di by dt, because we can write the formula d psi by dt is equal to capital L into di by dt, because flux linkage with respect to the time is equal to the amount of inductance which was offered in that conductor into current changes with respect to the time in the conductor. Therefore d psi by dt is equal capital L into di by dt with varying flux linkage, because flux linkage takes place, then only there exists that induced EMF. Because flux linkage takes place, from one conductor to another conductor in the transmission system, when the varying flux linkages linearly with the current, then the magnetic circuit has a constant called permeability. Because as we know the formula, Li is equal to N pi. Here, if you send this I to the left hand side, then the equation can become as Li is equal psi. Psi means N pi. That means Li is equal N pi or Li is equal N psi. Therefore, L is equal psi divided by I. L is equal psi by I and R. Therefore, psi is equal Li Weber per tons. Psi is equal Li Weber tons, where I is instantaneous value of the current which is flowing through the conductor, and psi is equal instantaneous flux linkage which was takes place from one conductor to another conductor. Therefore, psi is equal Li or N pi is equal Li. For a sinusoidal current, the flux linkage will also be sinusoidal. Once flux linkage takes place, then by that time there exists that voltage drop. The voltage drop due to the flux linkage is V. V is equal, generally we know the formula, V is equal IR. But in alternating quantity, V is equal, for inductance if you are going to take the reference, then V is equal XL into I. XL means we know the formula omega L. And omega L is nothing but omega L is nothing but here it is a reactive component which is expressed with J or I. So arbitrarily here I am representing that J. It is an imaginary term. Therefore, the voltage drop across the inductor due to the flux linkage, because it is a inductance na, so that's why I am going to represent it is a reactive element. So it is expressed in imaginary, that is V is equal J into XL into I. XL means omega L. Therefore, V is equal J into omega L into I volts. Omega into L into I. Li is nothing but psi. Again, I am going to replace the formula V is equal J omega psi volts. The mutual inductance between the two circuits is defined as the flux linkage takes place from one circuit to another circuit when the current in second circuit per ampere of current in the second circuit. That means the mutual inductance between the two circuits is defined as the flux linkage of one circuit to the current in the second circuit per ampere of current in the second circuit. Therefore, the current in the second circuit is because of current flowing in the first circuit and producing the flux, that flux links to secondary coil. Therefore, that psi is equal number of tons of primary coil N1 into and current in the primary coil, that is I. Next, inductance. Inductance is defined as the flux linkages per ampere is called as inductance. Mathematically, we can express the formula L is equal psi by I, or psi means N pi. Therefore, L is equal N pi by I, or Li is equal N pi, or Li is equal N into psi. Li is equal psi. Here, psi is nothing but flux linkages in Weber tons, and I is nothing but the current flowing through the conductor in amperes. The conductance of a transmission line is also a distributed parameter because it is distributed over the length of the transmission line. For the purpose of calculation, if I want to express this distributed element as a lumped parameter, then I can express the formula E is equal to d psi by dt, where psi is nothing but n pi. If I take n is constant to left hand side, E is equal n into d pi by dt, and again pi is directly proportional to current, and I can write the formula E is equal n into di by dt, or I can write the formula E is equal d psi by dt, where E is nothing but induced voltage in volts and psi is equal number of flux linkages of the circuit which is expressed in Weber tons. Therefore, N into psi is directly proportional to I and N into psi is equal Li. Therefore, the constant of proportionality is called as inductance, that is psi is equal Li by N, where L is nothing but inductance. And here E is equal to D into psi by dt. If I am going to substitute psi is nothing but like Li by N, I can write the formula D by dt Li by N. Here N is nothing but constant. If I take the N to the left hand side, L by N into di by dt, then N is constant. If I take that remaining equation, then E is equal L into di by dt. Therefore, the current I2 produces psi 12 flux linkages with circuit, then the mutual inductance M12 is equal psi 12 divided by I2. So then the voltage drop in the circuit 1 due to the flux linkage from one conductor to another conductor, that is V1 is equal J omega M12 into I2. M12 I2 is nothing but psi 12. There I can write the formula V1 is equal J omega psi 12 volts. Therefore, mutual inductance is very important in concerning an interference, because noise is caused due to the telephone influence factor because of the power lines. Thank you.